name is Geno Quintin. I am 23 years old, and I am a full-time martial artist at Impact Martial Arts Academy in Virginia Beach. I am the eldest of three kids. My family, there's my dad, my mom, and my two siblings are my brother and my sister. My brother and my sister act more as senior students. My brother and my sister act more as senior students and teachers. I'm the only one that professionally works at the school, but they're doing their own thing to further their training. I'm a senior instructor for Muay Thai, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, Filipino martial arts, and I lead the TDP Juniors program. TDP is the Total Defense Program that my father and I made. It's basically, in short, kids MMA. So we show them little bits of Muay Thai and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and it allows them to grow up and specialize in an art if they desire when they get older. I feel like my favorite one to practice is Filipino martial arts. My bias to it is because I myself am Filipino, and it holds a very close place in my heart because it's my birthright to know something about my culture. I think my favorite one to teach would probably be Muay Thai, because I have the most experience in doing it. I have experience in doing jiu-jitsu tournaments from 2012 to 2020, and for Muay Thai, as a mix, I did 5 MMA amateur fights from 2015 to late 2016. I definitely learned a lot about myself, and at the time, I was 18 and turning 19, so there's a lot of maturity that goes behind learning how to be a competitor. And I think now that I'm a bit older, I could definitely make a return to it.
Do you plan on it?
I definitely plan on making a return to MMA. I have some man salt I can put behind my fighting now.
This next fight is three-minute rounds in the SFL featherweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist standing at 6 feet tall. He weighed in at 145 pounds and represents Impact Martial Arts.
We just like.
So my goal for life is becoming independent. I think I've grown up with very many blessings, having amazing parents that taught me all the life skills that I need to know. So I'm trying to be like a content creator on TikTok and YouTube. I think eventually that'll spawn into traveling and doing like tours for stuff, and maybe eventually opening a second Impact somewhere.
Congratulations, you found my martial arts YouTube channel. You might know me from my TikTok, or you might just randomly find me on YouTube. Regardless, I look forward to sharing my tutorials, breakdowns, mindsets, and my passion about martial arts with you.
I don't think you ought to give me reason.
Great Sean on the beat, by the way.
My body different. Shorty said she trying to kick it. I'm in the mouth, son, like a dentist. Cooking up, I'm in the kitchen. Big bro wildin' trying to catch a victim. I took a L.
I think if I was to tell my younger self anything, I would say to be patient and trust in the training and the plan that you already have. As fun as it is to venture off and do things on your own, you're still going to have to come back and do the thing you were already told to do in the beginning. I think the meaning of life is to be happy. Being part of conflict and hardship, the only thing that people want to do is just be happy. And whether that's by yourself or if that includes other people, that's what I believe. I'm gonna borrow a quote that one of the kids explorers actually said in one of their black belt speeches. White belt mentality, black belt excellence. If you have the mentality that there's always more to learn and there's an abundance of things to improve on, and you do it the best way you can, it'll help with learning everything.